temporary tattoos are a great idea, especially for people who aren't quite sure if they want to really get a tattoo, because it's pretty permanent. I mean, you can have them lasered off, you can do other things, but it's costly. It takes a long time. For some people, it's really painful. And so it's good to kind of know that you really want something before you get it, kind of like a try before you buy. And so I've tried different types of temporary tattoos before in the past. I have real ones, but I kind of want some more, but I just don't want to get them in certain places and then regret it later on. Like, oh, I don't really like it there. So every so often I'll put on a temporary tattoo just to kind of see how I feel about certain locations, like on my forearm or something visible, because none of mine are visible. It's just a personal thing, you know? And so, we have companies out there who have just, you know, temporary tattoos. You can find them on Etsy, you can find them on eBay, pretty much anywhere. And there are, you know, things like Inkbox. I've never tried Inkbox before. I would like to try them sometime, but I haven't made it there yet. However, one company kind of caught my attention, and it's a company called Momentary Ink. And so I ordered, because why not? Their temporary tattoo prices are pretty reasonable too. I believe, I don't remember how much I paid for this, but anyway, it comes in a package like this, and over here it says, I like tats like that. Yeah, so it's cute, and it's Momentary Ink Realistic Temp Tats, or Realistic Temporary Tats. So let's open this up without destroying anything and see what we got. So this is what was on the inside. It just says Momentary Ink Tats. Then on the back, Momentary Ink, thousands of designs at momentaryink.com, which is where you can go to find these. They have tons of different options there. On top of that, they also have a service where if you have a design of your own that you would like to possibly have tattooed on your body, but you're not sure if you really want that, draw it out or have it drawn out and send it to them, and they will do a custom order and turn that into a temporary tattoo for you to try out to see if it's something that you really, really, really want. So, let's see what's on the inside. See, and that's why you look, because I would have missed the tattoo altogether. Okay, that's all that's in there. It comes with instructions on how to apply the tattoo. You got this, which is the tattoo that I decided to get. I can't remember the name of it right now, but I will leave a link to it in the description box down below. So there's that, and then on the inside of here, got this little bag. How easy it is to open it with nails. Here we go. Maybe. Okay. So then on the inside of this, you have, it is, what is this? Okay, this is the finger wrap. And this is the real teal. And this is actually to get rid of the shine on the tattoo. So yeah, so okay, so it says clean and dry skin, no oil, makeup, or hair, which I've already done. Cut off the excess white from around the edges of the design. Remove clear plastic cover from front of design. Press tattoo on desired location, design side down. Soak the back with dripping wet paper towel for 20 plus seconds. Dab around the edges until paper slides off naturally. Let it dry for about 3 minutes and put on the finger wrap. Shake real teal, pour onto wrap. Start with half a bottle, half, dang. I gotta use this much. that's a lot. Start with half a bottle, apply more only if the shine remains. Then don't bend or twist skin for 1 hour or 1+ hour after applying, so 1 hour or more. And then avoid friction, rubbing, sweating when possible, and enjoy. Well, it's winter, and the majority of my shirts are going to cover this, but that, you know, that's okay. This is why we try things, right? Just trying it on. It says on here, biggest mistakes, applying too much real teal, twisting area immediately, and sweaty activities too soon. So don't be doing stuff that's going to make you sweat. Okay, so let's try this out. Okay. I am going to kind of trim the extra white areas from around here. Be really careful with doing that. Okay, so cut as much of the white off as I could. What's next instruction? Remove the clear plastic cover from the front of the design. Okay. Now where I want to place it, oh, like right here, right in there. So, which I guess I should have decided which angle I wanted it first. Okay, yeah. Right here is where I want to put it. So you press that down. It's a little crooked, but whatever. And then you place it on the back of the tattoo for 20 seconds. And it says to dab around the edges until the paper slides off naturally, which it is starting to do. Oh. Huh. Okay, so the whole thing really did come. All right. It's just to let it dry. So, be back in 3 minutes. It's time. Okay. So this is what it's looking like. Oof, not too shabby, eh? Okay, so this is going to be fun because I'm right-handed and I have to do this with my left. That's okay. I'm somewhat ambidextrous. Let's roll this the right way. Okay, so putting a little finger doohickey thing, putting the little finger doohickey on. Okay, so, oh, hold on. It says put on the finger wrap and shake the real teal. Let me shake it with this hand. Okay. So I feel like I've already messed up. Okay, so start with half the bottle, half of the bottle. Okay, it doesn't say exactly, like, I don't know if you're supposed to just, like, pat it on. I don't know how. I would imagine that you're not supposed to rub it in. I'm not sure. Oh, it is drying up, though. Okay. I'm going to try and do the edges first. That's just me. I'm assuming that there's no real, like, particular way to do this. No right or wrong way. Well, never mind. I'm sure there's a wrong way, but there's probably more than one way to put this, to apply this. Okay, so this is what it looks like after the real seal is on. And listen, now I understand why they said to use half the bottle. I didn't use quite half the bottle, but I might go back and retouch a few areas and stuff like that, but it takes all the shininess away. And you know when you put on a temporary tattoo and it's got like that kind of ripply look a little bit? It's shiny and it's ripply and it takes away all of that. So now it says to don't bend or twist the skin for about an hour. So I'm going to do something else for an hour and I will be back and let you know what I think. So far, so good. This is nice. This is 9.
Okay, so here we go. This is what it looks like. I know the angle is horrible. I apologize. I'm sorry. Okay, so this is what it looks like. As you can see, it's not shiny or wrinkly or anything like that, like a regular temporary tattoo would be. You almost can't even tell, at least on camera, I don't think you can tell where the lines are around it. In person, I can see it a little bit, but you know, who knows what it'll look like after I shower, too? Like, I don't know what it's going to look like after showers and baths and stuff like that. And I actually don't know how long it's supposed to stay on. Hopefully it stays on for more than a day or two, because that's normally about all the use I get out of a temporary tattoo. And then it says, what does it say? To remove it, you soak and rub with rubbing alcohol or baby oil, just like a regular temporary tattoo. This is what my little temporary tattoo looks like. It's going to be hard to not, you know, what is it? It's going to be hard to not bend or twist it because of the location. Because really, like, if I just do this, you see where it, well, might not be able to see it on camera as much, but I can see it in person. It's just, it kind of wrinkles up, but then as soon as I put my arm back out, it just goes back to being flat again. So I don't know. We'll see. We shall see how long this lasts. They always seem to have some kind of coupon code going on. I don't have one because I'm not sponsored by them. If you want to sponsor me, though, you can. I'm okay with that. But they also have a rewards program. The rewards program, you rack up points on there super easily. I got my first 800 points on there without even having bought anything. And you need, I think, 500 to get $5 off. 500. I can't remember the point system. You have to, why is my hair doing that? You have to go to the website and sign up for their rewards program and just make it work. Make it work. But like I said, they also have a lot of coupon codes running a good chunk of the time. So I think, I want to say this one was $12. This was the small version. I think it's Bouquet of Roses. I will leave the name and a link down below to this particular tattoo. But I think, I want to say I paid $12, or it was $12, and I used one of my codes and stuff to not have to pay that much for it. But even if I had, $12 is really, it's not bad for a temporary tattoo, especially when it comes with all of these extra, you know, extra steps and stuff. So yeah, so far so good. So far I like this. If you're thinking about getting a tattoo, or if you just want to play around with temporary tattoos, just because, I would definitely check out Momentary Ink. Like I said, they have tons of tattoos to choose from, and at varying price points as well. Like, this particular one came in an extra small, which I think was, don't quote me on it, it might have been $9. Extra small, small, large, and then extra large. And so this one that I have is 3 inches by 3 inches. The next one up, I think, was 5 by 5. Again, don't quote me on that. Go look at it. So you can get a teeny tiny tattoos, or you can get really big ones. It just depends on what you like. And like I said, the price point is good for what you're getting. So yeah, go check them out. Go check them out, momentaryink.com. Again, I'll leave a link to them down below. I hope this finds you doing well. And go get yourself a little temporary tattoo. I can't talk anymore because I'm hungry. Okay, have a good one. Bye.